I'm going to try and explain what color spaces are and how to use them in the easiest way possible using an example of food. So imagine you have a plate in front of you, and imagine you have an oven the same size as the plate. So let's say in this oven you can only put a chicken and a potato in there. You cook the food, it's ready, and you put the food on the plate. So what do you put on the plate? You put the chicken and the potato. That's the only stuff that can fit in the oven. But imagine your oven is 3 times as big as that plate. So now you have space to put in chicken, lasagna, garlic bread, whatever you want. Now, your plate still has the same size, right? The amount of food on the plate is still the same, but because your oven is way bigger, the types of food that you can put on the plate has changed. And that's the best analogy I can make between color spaces. So the plate represents Rec 709. That's the screen. That's all screens pretty much people use, okay? So that's the plate. When you record like RAW or LOG or any other type of bigger color space, that's the oven. So the bigger the oven, the more ingredients you can chuck in there and the more diverse your plate can be at the end. If you want to change the plate, right, the food that's on the plate, you don't change it when it's on the plate, you change it when it's in the oven. Meaning, if you record something in RAW or LOG, you change it in RAW and LOG, and then the result you see on your plate. In the oven, you can wangle jangle, and then all of a sudden your plate looks different. And that's how you also approach color grading. When you're color grading, you want to work in the oven. You want all the information you can get. And then when the food's ready, you present it on the plate. I hope that made sense to you. It made sense to me. If you have questions, just leave them below in the comments. I'll try and answer them. I think that's kind of like the easiest way I can explain it.